the big challenges for India is to spur and boost the domestic demand. However, it is complicated by rising inflation. India's wholesale price index inflation jumped to 14.2% from previous 12.5% in the last year, primarily due to the rising food and fuel prices. This made the double-digit inflation with a 12-year high with 14.2%. The center is keep this momentum going. It's how to keep this momentum going to tackle this inflation, to control this inflation. The deal with this pipeline at the present is the best time it has seen in the past few years. And the government should take a calibrated approach with nuance and proper assisting sector that are the most vulnerable, including tourism, hospitality and retail industry. It should offer those targeted support to MSME sector that are finding it very difficult to meet the production commitment due to the lack of access to the credit. The center should be this investment agenda, which will supply much needed capital, and focused on national infrastructure pipeline, which will plan to spend 111 lakh crore by 2024-2025 financial year, and its production-linked incentive schemes, which offer the support to 13 sectors with a corpus of lakh crore. The urban poor need support. This would also kickstart demand and lead to more investment by the private sector. And some economists say the government should not shy away from increasing the fiscal deficit to boost spending if needed. The government is willing to spend much awaited on that 11 crore, this lakh crore estimate proposal by 2024-2025 financial year that is based on this production linked incentive scheme with the 13th sector with a corpus of 2 lakh crore. That is itself a massive, massive investment for the infrastructure sector in the history of Indian economy. The Indian economy will create a history in this infrastructure development project, in this area, that will also create those a huge demand and boost the economy with lot of job opportunity, lot of new skilled labor, and the workforce will require to get back its spending mode, because it's the main driver for demand in the economy. With income downs and job skills scarce in the big picture level, the spending push for demand is not quite visible on the horizon, and the industry higher demand means higher sales revenue. The center and RBI have a policy tools to influence some of these factors, like the high commodity prices in global market, which are driving up the input cost as harder to influence. The optimism has not translated into the big ticket investment on the ground, and with some experts saying those corporate spending is restricted to just a few large businesses. Industrial corporate production remained with industrial production index, it grew at 3.2% on a year-on-year, at the lowest in 8 months. Automotive production was badly hit during this festive season as a result of a shortage of semiconductors. And the main issue is raging around the world, the large scarcity for the semiconductor equipment is hampered the most in auto sector, and other many sector involving 150 countries are affected by the semiconductor shortage. The new panic situation has arisen for the semiconductor industry, and Japan is already faced a massive loss due to its semiconductor scarcity. situation in auto sector than the half for automobile industry as the Japanese driving the automobile industry for a long time. It has a maximum damage and paying those maximum damage for the semiconductors. I think as those economics are based apparently high growth rate largely due to the low baseline in the previous year. The contraction has not been overcome. A sustained recovery, India did robust growth this year. The sustainability for the recovery will also depend on whether the central rolls out a new stimulus or boost those growth through the infrastructure spending. There is a growing clamor for targeted stimulus for the hospitality sector, small and medium enterprises. For the informal sector, it would take the form of urban employment schemes similar to MNREGA. Some economists also say the government should not shy away from increasing this fiscal deficit to boost those spending. And the medium-term governments also focus on national infrastructure pipeline policy as a part of, as earlier that we mentioned, the announced plan of this huge massive project for 2024-2025 financial year, based on production link incentive scheme that supports the starting sector of 4% of 2 lakh crore as a total estimate, as I mentioned, and that the PLI incentive needs to disburse as soon as possible. As we all know that Omicron is and some other issues are also developing. I mean, that create those situations that economy watchers can only keep their fingers crossed, but the trade grows. The same sector can suffer the most in the past 2 years will be hit again. It's where the center will need to support the urban poor and those dependent on service sector like hotels and transportation, which are already performing below the pre-pandemic level. These investment areas the government need to focus on is these investment areas that Air India to Tata Group have been released as for these investment, I mean, sector, that's the target raising the 1.75 lakh crore for the investment, privatization and asset monetization. But progress has been very slow. That is but linked to sustained recovery to increase the incomes and employment. Once you consume, there will be more investment at the various cycle. And the will start. That's the way we optimist about the stimulus and this India's GDP now almost 220 lakh crore. The stimulus of 1.2 lakh crore will not help and will only put the fiscal deficit under pressure. What we need is those private investment. Conversation about how to this situation has been raised for the sake of India's economy. How to structure those India's economy that will be important, how that will boost the growth, that the GDP growth for the estimated path that we assume that at least that we hope for that 8-9% annual, that's the requirement to achieve the desired policy, that the fulfill of this desired policy to be maintained and concentrating its effort on tackling the problem areas will be critical for a more sustainable growth in the coming quarters. And in case of compounded annual growth rate for the past 2 years, the market has been very flat. We can see the growth, but it's a very low base. The trajectory is very low. That's the economic recovery is just the way to sustain, but achieve full growth potential is yet to be done. So, depending upon how you define those steps, we have to set those recovery as the way we need to watch and see what how is going to be a better way to maintain its growth in future. That's all for now. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.